Hello dear viewers, welcome back to Medchem Companion channel. Today we will discuss the chemical classification of beta lactam antibiotics. Antibiotics are the compounds synthesized by microorganism and which kill or inhibit the growth of other microorganism. Usually the beta lactam antibiotics contain a beta lactam ring. So beta lactam ring is a cyclic amide ring. This is the structure of this cyclic amide nucleus. This four membered cyclic amide is known by the name lactam. This is your chemical classification of penicillins. Penicillin usually have penam basic skeleton. What is the structure of penam nucleus? So when this beta lactam nucleus is fused with thiazolidine nucleus, then the structure so obtained, this structure is known by the name penam. So all the penicillin are derivative of this penam nucleus. The numbering of this penam nucleus is very typical. The numbering start from this sulfur: first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. On the second position of this penam nucleus, there are geminal dimethyl group, means two methyl groups are present here. On the third position of this penam nucleus, there is a carboxyl group. And on the sixth position of this penam nucleus, there is an amino group. So the structure which is obtained now, this whole structure is known by the name 6-amino penicillinic acid. This is your penicillinic acid. Now the different example of penicillin which we will learn in the next session, all different penicillin have substitution at this amino group. Actually there is an acylation of this amino group. So after acylation the general structure so obtained is like this, C double bond O R. So all the different penicillin have changes at this position only. Whole structure remains as such. While we will study the example, this whole structure remains common in all penicillin. Only the changes takes place at this R position. So let's begin our discussion. Begin our example of different class of this penicillin. So the first class of penicillin is your natural penicillin. Natural penicillin. And natural penicillin have two example. First one is your example first. First is your penicillin G. Penicillin G. Chemically it is known by the name benzyl penicillin. Benzyl penicillin means this penicillin have benzyl nucleus over this position. So what is benzyl nucleus? So CH2 and a benzene nucleus. This is the structure of this penicillin G, benzyl nucleus. Another example is there in natural penicillin, penicillin V. Chemically it is known by the name phenoxymethylpenicillin. So where are the changes? So changes only at this position. This methyl group remains as such, here oxygen and then benzene nucleus. So this is the structure of your phenoxy. This is your phenoxy group. Phenoxy, methyl, penicillin. This is class number one. Now class number second. Class number second is classified as beta lactamase resistant penicillin. Beta lactamase resistant penicillin. So beta lactamase resistant penicillin is also known by the name penicillinase resistant penicillin. This is also known by the name penicillin, penicillinase resistant penicillin. And the example which comes under this class is first methicillin. And methicillin has structure, its name include meth means methyl. So it has structure in which methyl group is there. So here nothing, a phenyl ring is there. And on this two position, there is one methyl and here one methyl. This is the structure of your methicillin. Now, again, there is another example which comes under this penicillinase resistant penicillin is oxacillin. So, oxacillin has another ring over here. Oxacillin has another ring over here. Its structure look like this. Like this. CH3, and at this position here your benzene nucleus, and this benzene nucleus here have single hydrogen and here also single hydrogen. This is the structure of your oxacillin. Its name have oxa. So here and isooxazole nucleus is there. This is isooxazole. When this nitrogen, if this nitrogen is placed at third position, then this become oxazole. But he, this nitrogen is present at this nearby carbon to the oxygen. So this ring become isooxazole. So oxacillin has this structure. Then there is another derivative, cloxacillin. Cloxacillin have at this position only chlorine. So this become your cloxacillin, cloxa. So this is about your class second. Now we will move on to the next class, class number 3. So class number 3 is classified as, class number 3 is classified as broad spectrum penicillin. And this broad spectrum penicillin is again divided into two subclass. The first subclass is aminopenicillin. So what is the structure of this aminopenicillin? So let's look at this structure. So this group remains common. At this position, this acyl position, there is a single carbon, and on this single carbon there is a phenyl nucleus. But the aminopenicillin have example ampicillin. So where this amino group is placed? So this amino group is placed at this position, NH2. So this become your ampicillin. There is another example in this class, aminopenicillin, amoxicillin. Amoxicillin. So amoxicillin has only hydroxyl group at this para position. So this nucleus will become your amoxicillin. This is the example of subclass aminopenicillin. Now the second class has, the second class is carboxypenicillin. Carboxypenicillin. And in carboxypenicillin, the example of antibiotic is carbenicillin. And carbenicillin has slight changes. At this amino position in carbenicillin, there is a carboxyl group. This is the structure of your carboxypenicillin. Now we will move on to the next class, class number fourth. Class number fourth. So class number fourth is classified as uridopenicillin. Uridopenicillins. So uridopenicillin is nothing but they are derivative of ampicillin. They are what? Derivative of ampicillin. So which example, the example uridopenicillin have an example, which example? This is a best example, azelocillin. Azelocillin. What is the structure of azelocillin? So actually this azelocillin is a derivative of what? Ampicillin, and ampicillin has NH2 group here. So azelocillin is what? So azelocillin nothing but azelocillin has here this functionality, C double bond O, then again N, then again this indolin nucleus and a carboxyl group. So only this functionality is different here. All this structure is similar to that of ampicillin. So this is your azelocillin. This uridopenicillin have another example which is known by the name piperacillin. So what is the changes in piperacillin? As the name indicate, piperine means somehow a piperidine ring is there. So at this position, this is the structure of your piperacillin. Now the last class of penicillin is your newer class, a fifth class, number fifth. Class number fifth is penicillin with C6-amidino west end group. Penicillin with C6-amidino west end group. And this class include an example, mesillinum. So what is the structure of this mesillinum? So as the name indicate, C6-amidino group. So on this C6 position, this is 6th position, so on this C6 position there is an amidino group. So amidino group means a group in which nitrogen is double bonded. So here the changes is like this. This is your nitrogen, and this nitrogen is bonded to a carbon on which a single hydrogen is there, and this carbon is directly connected with a 7-member azepine, a 7-membered aromatic ring. So this is the example of your mycelinum. And now there is another class which can be counted as class number 6, miscellaneous. So miscellaneous class have several different structured penicillin. For example, bacampicillin, and there is another example, quinicillin. So this is all about your chemical classification of penicillin. I hope you understand the classification of penicillin. In the next session, we will discuss the another class of beta-lactam antibiotic, cephalosporin. Thank you.